In this video, we will attempt to create a V groove on the inside of this frame. The non-planar nature of this frame adds to the challenge. The converging point of the V needs to be halfway through the thickness of the frame. At the same time, it should also be an offset of the shape of the frame. I'm going to go through two methods here. The first method is adapted from the workflow proposed by 3P Lighting, which involves surfacing. We want to create a surface body that cuts through the middle of the frame thickness. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Select the top face. Enter an offset distance that is half of the thickness of the frame. Next, we want to create offset surfaces from these inside faces of the frame. Repeat the offset face command. Select these inside faces. Adjust the offset. This offset controls the depth of the V groove. Let's hide the solid body to show the two surface bodies that we have created. Go to Modify, Trim. Select this surface body as a trim tool. Select this portion of the surface body to remove. This portion should turn red. Right-click on the Trim tool in the Bodies folder and remove. Bring back the solid body. We want to remove the existing inside faces of the frame. Make sure that the Surface tab is still active. Control select these two faces and press the Delete key. The solid body now becomes a hollow surface body. This also reveals the previously trimmed surface body. We now have a scaffold on which to build a V groove. Go to Create, Loft. Check on the Chain Selection option. Select this chain of edges as the first profile. Select this chain of edges as the second profile. This gives us the top half of the V groove. Repeat the loft command. Select this chain of edges as the first profile. Select this chain of edges as the second profile. This gives us the bottom half of the V groove. We no longer need the surface body created during the first offset. So right-click and remove. This is not a fully watertight surface body, but it is still hollow. Go to Modify, Stitch, and stitch all these surfaces into a solid body. The next method is a swept cut, and this was proposed by a few contributors. I did run into some problems with this method. I'm still going to present my workflow here for the sake of open discussion. With this method, the first step is also to create an offset face from the top. Initially, I had wanted to use this edge as a path, but you can see that it does not cut through the solid completely. So let's use this offset surface to split the inside faces of the frame. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select these two faces to split. For splitting tool, click on the Select box. And select the offset surface body. Extend the splitting tool. Right-click to remove the splitting tool. We now have a path for sweeping. Because this is a non-linear path, we need a plane that is normal to the path. Go to Construct, Plane Along Path. I'm going to select this segment of the path. I'm going to position the plane halfway along this segment. Begin a sketch on this plane. Select the slice option to give us a cross-sectional view. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select these two faces. Let's hide the body for clarity. This gives us two lines which represent the intersection between these two faces and the sketch plane. Draw a line from the split point. Adjust the line until a parallel constraint is inferred to the projected lines. This point will define the depth of the groove. Set this line to construction. Draw a straight line from this point. In the forum, you will read that you need to slightly overbuild this profile for the sweep to work. So I'm going to draw this line beyond this point. Set a coincident constraint between the line and this point. Mirror this line. And complete this triangle. Bring back the solid body. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Create, Sweep. select the profile. For path, click on the select box and control select these two edges. The orientation should be set to perpendicular so that the profile adjusts its orientation as it moves along the path. If you compare this with the first method, you can see that the sweep does not create sharp edges here. If we go back and look at the sweep path, you can see that it is not simply a flat circle. It also has a certain curvature when looking from the side. My guess is that the profile can only adjust itself based on the circle, but it struggles to adjust according to the curvature on the side. I might be wrong here. Do let me know your thoughts below.